How we going, guys, and welcome back. If you are just joining and haven't seen the first one, it was a under $5 game playthrough. I figured I'd just continue it on. I literally forgot to start recording and walked over and pressed this button and the door opened, for once, though we didn't need to do a puzzle. I'm going to flash to the other world, just to see what it looks like. So we get a meat hook for nothing. So the button doesn't work in this world. The plate's covering something. Yeah, we'd have to fucking clean it off. We'd have to lift it with the meat hook. It's down the manhole. Bah. There's probably something I'm meant to do. Probably is something. So for the moment, yeah. We'll go through to the hospital front. We'll see what's there. Painter and a policeman. Terps. Whatever, with the whole lot of the paint, it will notice it's gone and alert the officer. Oh, actually, I turned on the thing. Can I smash it? Smash it down.
No.
Not the tree. Oh, so I need the turpentine. How do I get the turpentine though? It's probably a container or something in here. Is it? Hacksaw? So now we'll go underneath. I like this time travel style, just like the quick change. I'm just gonna say, I don't know if anyone's ever tried to cut through anything who would watch this. Oh, it's a bit sus. I wouldn't be grabbing syringes out from underneath things. Should we switch across? Sure. Oh, we could light that, couldn't we?
Man.
Oh, that is what we have to do. We have to go back first. There we go. Get the turpentine. Go back down. Light the wood. Come back up. It's like, I don't know. Not super complicated, but more. I don't want to say annoying, but probably more backwards and forwards than there needs to be. But that is how these games go.
Whoa!
Off we go. I do like that though, just the changing. Swapping between future and past. But Burt Reynolds doesn't care. He's just. He's off on his own. Listen, now I can just walk straight in. That was easy. The corpse. Say ouch. Car batteries don't do that. So what's the idea? I could hear some knocking when I was in here before. Look at that bunk. It's open. What do you reckon we're going to find? Care about the fucking floor. Or do I want to jump down, do I? Full medical mojo, hematology, growth rate, pandemic. Took your staple and now I even also. Same day. Do I want to jump down? Guess so. Keep saying ow. Oh, it's the guy. Cut his tag off. Take it. As if. It just happens to be a key there. Should talk to the doctor. I didn't even mean to click on that. Whoops. Not really whoops, but, you know. Here's something else. So we got a key. Change the time. So what's that key for? Oh, I know what it's for. His fucking desk.
Damn. Huh.
Maybe not. Fuck me.
Nice.
It's a lot of zapping around. Poor Burt Reynolds. Off we go. So there's an epidemic.
Here, yeah. Out on the road, everything seems so normal. Same moon, same night sky. After an hour of driving, it's easy to forget all about that dead world back there. How could Lambert have survived, though?
Because he's mad.
If he came from the future, how did he not die along with everybody else? I just saw his body in the morgue. Now I'm driving out to talk to him alive. How does that work? Do you just leave a copy of yourself every time you use the box? Is that it? Are there copies of me all over the place now? What if he's not there? What if I changed something and he's not alive at all? Maybe all of this has been completely pointless. Maybe there's nothing I can do after all. Maybe these will be my last days, along with everybody else's. Ugh, the thought ties my stomach in knots. No, I better just not think about it and carry on.
I was gonna say,
did I bring enough gas?
Wonder what
God, I hope I brought enough gas.
Oh, excuse me. Wonder what happened if he time traveled, but it's night time, so they've figured that out. He didn't bring enough gas. It ran out. Would he bring gas? Danger, crocodiles, no swimming. I wouldn't drink out of it, but if the last few hours told me anything, it'd probably be of some use.
Nice. When I was a little lad, and so my mother told me, Way, haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
That was a shit song. That was pure coincidence that I got a tail light and not something else. Ooh, crocodile signs. I haven't seen one.
Man.
Clearly putting them out. We're in. Like sneaky badgers. Well, there is a crocodile, holy shit. Pick up the fish. Oh. I could see the key to start with anyway, but... Need some gas. Clearly something else. We killed the fish. That's awesome. So do I give the fish to the crocodile and then it'll leave? I doubt it. Like that would happen. Oh, chainsaw. Can we use a moonshine for it? That'll be pretty cool. Moonshine's basically fuel. That is what we have to do. That's amazing. This game's actually been pretty alright for the most part. That's incredible. He'd just be sitting at home. Some cunt's just cut through his front door.
Hmm.
probably has his gun.
Boy.
You would guess. The paintings are actually pretty cool. He'll be in here.
Nice.
Can I play the piano? We clearly have to use this. Some of the stuff is just so obvious. It's insane. His time travel device. It's the time machine, actually. So what would I use the globe for then? Turning globe. Dude, I can't actually get to the fucking... So what can I use then? Can I use his clock?
Boy.
I'm not sure. So I can't use it here, can I? Okay. Water collection, raised beds, fireplace, more vegetables, a twig. I would take the lantern, but... So I gotta go up and down between them. Probably use the still, I guess. Oh, I can't get back outside. So I need to use the, go back upstairs, go out of this time, fill up the extinguisher. Burn the vines, I presume. Oh shit. Start the fire with the fucking sticks. Burn the vines down. Easy. Now we can go check out what's in that room. We're getting further and further along. March 1971, I've prepared a logbook document just in case something happens to me and someone else needs to continue my work. This one's different from the rest. Light it up, I guess.
Whoa.
The last wine bottle of the rack. No progress this week. 2 months of cold nights since that imbecile broke my bedroom door. Last night I nearly got mauled by a bear, so I finally caved and built new doors. Idiot proof. Maybe it means us.
Stop right there!
Whoa, wait! Mr. Lambert, sir, it's me, Joe!
I don't know you, What are you doing in my house?
You sent me here, remember?
I've done no such thing. For an intruder, you're not very bright, you know that? For all the commotion you caused getting in here, you might as well have brought a bulldozer. Now, you have exactly 5 seconds to explain what you're doing here. Or so help me God, I'm pulling this trigger and sending you on your way. 5.
I was sent here.
4.
By you!
3.
You told me to find you, to warn you about the end of the world.
2.
You were old, with white hair, and you got shot. Oh, God, please don't shoot me, Mr. Lambert. This, you gave me this. It's an chrono. It's a time machine.
I gave you that?
Yes!
I've never seen anything like it. But on the back, that's my family's signet. I made this? It's simply magnificent. I gave this to you? Why? Who are you?
Name's Joe, sir. I'm just a janitor at the Archon building. I found you in a room with a big, round door in the basement labs this morning, and you were dying. You said you'd come from 40 years in the future to stop the end of the world. I guess I was the only one around, so you gave me this and told me to find you and tell you all this, and I've been there. The future, I mean. A bunch of times. And you were right, Mr. Lambert. Everyone's gone.
My God, so it did come to pass. They really did it, those greedy goddamn bastards. I told them this would happen. Wait, I was dying? How?
You said you'd been shot. I had to actually find you at the morgue to get this address.
Shot? By whom? No, wait. Don't say anything else. You succeeded in finding me, which means anything you tell me from this point on could alter the course of action that brought you to my doorstep. The less I know, the better. So, you've seen the future. What did you see?
It's like a bad dream, sir. Everyone's gone. Buildings are coming apart. It's all just quiet. What happened, Mr. Lambert?
It is Dr. Lambert. And considering all the effort you just went through to find me, not to mention bearing witness to the horrific outcome of the biggest breakthrough in the history of science, I suppose I owe you some kind of explanation. I was 24 when I got hired by Archon, or Athena, as it was called back then. Athena was one of the many weapons R&D companies formed during the Second World War. Unlike other R&D companies that had retooled themselves to pursue peacetime activities after the war, Athena had made enough money to continue chasing the next big thing in defense technologies. They were betting the farm on post-war Soviet expansion, raising the level of government paranoia to create a lucrative market for esoteric weapons research. I'd say they made the right bet. Still a theoretical physicist at MIT, my thesis on the possibility of time travel via dimensional membranes got published shortly after I was hired in 1961. Company heads were so impressed, they gave me a team and a budget. Development exceeded even my own expectations. And after only 6 years, we had the first primitive version of the time machine up and running. Our first successful trials involved sending simple objects into the future with a timed return. But with Archon running out of money, that was all the company bigwigs needed to secure a big fat contract with the Department of Defense. Apparently, we had sold them on the idea that the technology could be used to go back in time and strangle communism in its cradle. The reality, of course, was that it couldn't. Due to the laws of causality, you can't travel back in time beyond the point where time travel was invented. And sooner or later, we had to explain that to our benefactors. When they started pushing for progress reports, Archon management had to come clean, but instead chose to ease government concerns by claiming the technology could be used to bring back advanced weapons from the future. But this too was a lie. At this point, we'd already had our first of many human trials, and we knew there would be no weapons. In fact, our results were as terrifying as they were baffling. Time pilots returned frenzied and confused, raving about empty streets and human remains. At first, we assumed the city had suffered a Soviet attack in the near future and had been evacuated as a result. But as we pushed on further, the terrible reality became clear. Time pilots started returning fatally ill, dying within a day or two from painful convulsions. Some never returned. We lost several pilots, machine prototypes, and other equipment. When the first contamination erupted in the lab, we were completely unprepared, losing three lab technicians to what we later identified as an incredibly aggressive airborne virus. Although we weren't equipped to handle biohazards of this magnitude, management insisted we contain and study it. To keep our pilots and the virus alive long enough to study, we co-opted experimental cryotechnology from another project, Lazarus, and established a makeshift virus lab. Once again, the bigwigs managed to spin our setbacks into a success story for the Department of Defense, now claiming that the virus could be cultivated for use as a biological weapon. The team threatened to resign, but outrage was swiftly quenched by promises of massive salary increases and stock options. I didn't take the bribe. I'd witnessed the lethal efficiency of the virus firsthand. I knew there was only one way this was going to end, so I handed in my resignation and set up shop out here. For over a year, I've been working to recreate the technology to bring me back in time and prevent mankind's extinction from ever happening. And now you're here, the harbinger of doom at my doorstep, wearing a boiler suit. Who could have imagined that Judgment Day would begin like any other Monday in May? In any case, unfathomable as it may be that you were able to bring this information to me, knowing is only half the battle. Preventing the outbreak will require more than just your tenacity.
Me? Wait, what?
Yes, I'm afraid I must rely on you one more time. You must go back to Archon and prevent the outbreak.
No, I'm really honored and everything, but...
Believe me, you're the last person in the world I want to entrust with this. And I mean that quite literally. But by this time tomorrow, the entire city will have succumbed to chaos, panic, and death. You're here now, and you're all I've got.
Wait, but what about you? Can't you fix this, Doc? Don't you have a plan?
I can't go myself, because that would break the law of causality. The only reason you are here to warn me now is because I was there to send you. And the only reason I was there to send you is because I was able to bring my work to fruition here.
But...
We've no time to waste. It's the only way. You told me you found me this morning, correct?
Yes, but...
That means I failed to stop it, and the outbreak has already begun. The time pilot for today's trial must have brought the virus back from the future, which then somehow got out of the containment chamber and spread. That pilot is Patient Zero. I need you to destroy the supercomputer system controlling the time machine. All the research data is stored there too. You must destroy it before the time machine departs. I'm reconfiguring your device to send you back one day earlier. This should allow you ample time to return to Archon and get inside. On the other shore from here, about 500 yards down the road, is a rest stop. You'll find a van there, fueled and ready to go.
Oh, I already have a ride.
Which won't be there yesterday, you ninny. Now stop interrupting me. One last thing, and I need you to listen carefully because this is very, very important. Make sure you do not meet the earlier version of you.
Why? What will happen?
No one knows for sure. It's one of the conundrums not yet accounted for. There are theories, of course. None of them pleasant. Now, let's get you ready.
Well, that was an awfully long talking scene. Driving an awesome V-dub van.
How did I get myself into this? I nearly got killed trying to reach Dr. Lambert, thinking he had a plan.
I think we're going to be the one who shoots him.
And it turns out it's me. I'm the plan.
We'll shoot the doctor.
At least I don't have to walk back. This van's not as cool as the ambulance, but it has its charm. And it sure was nice of him to pack me lunch. I wish he'd pack me a can opener for the beans, though. And some gas for the Bunsen burner. But I'm sure I'll think of something. Got several hours of driving ahead of me, after all. It'll be almost morning before I get to Archon. I just hope I have enough time.
We probably had the tinfoil hat on as well. So, the strip club it is, or nightclub.
Hey.
Please do not press this button.
Right on time. Welcome to the hippest joint in town, my man. We so underground, we literally four steps below the tarmac. Now, what can I do for you?
Actually, I just saw the sign. I don't even know what I'm doing here.
Of course you do. You here because you heard this place was jumping. And you heard right, my man. We got grooves so bad, we make Studio 54 look like off-season fat camp.
It's kind of empty in here.
Yeah, no, I know, man. We literally just opened like 5 minutes ago. They coming. They all coming. Don't you worry. You're gonna be knee-deep in honeys before you know it. Believe that. Now, what can old Cedric get you?
I don't know. I could use a beer, I guess.
A beer? A beer in here? You embarrassing me here, bub. I got university degrees in mixonomy and mixology. I mix mojitos for the gods.
Just a beer, please.
Man, you really going through with all that, ain't you? All right, seeing as you're the first patron of the night and all, I'll let you have that one. That'll be a dollar.
A dollar? Jeez. You sure weren't kidding about this being a high-class joint.
Look, I don't jack the prices, kid. This here establishment is just geared towards a more, shall we say, discerning clientele.
But it's empty.
Yeah. Thank you, man. I got that. I know it's empty, all right? I can see that. I told you, we just opened. Now, you gonna pay for that beer or what?
I think I left my wallet in my jacket. I'll be right back.
Oh, I'll be here.
Oh!
Hey, don't you...
Sorry. Just looking. Hang on.
Anything more alarming than the peasant's unprecedented incubation period is the horrific physical toll it takes on the human bozal. As you're aware, the media has been brewing up a storm. Over the past few days, there's been a highly contagious disease that has claimed more than 600 lives.
Hang on.
I believe you can use it with a parking meter. Sweet. Someone's welding. So, no, not really horror. I need something else before I can get that. Need some metal, I guess. Give me the beer, Funky.
I've changed my mind. For the money, give me the fanciest drink you've got.
A challenge, huh? All right, I'll bite. Prepare to be dazzled. One rainbow frosted hot lava slushy deluxe with a twist coming right up. It is complete. Now, you could just let it sit there for a while, have the layers settle for that smooth sensation. Or you could have it right away and blow out your taste buds with sheer delight. Your choice.
Whoa. Man, that's... It's like the universe.
Go under, use the ball in the fucking darkness so we can get that wrench.
Whoa. Sir, would you kindly step up?
Thank you. So what would I use this on then? So how do I get in there?
Whoa. Man, that's... It's like the universe just revealed all of its secrets inside my mouth.
Nothing. That's what I do, fucking screws over it from this side. I'm sort of stuck. I don't know what to do.
Yes.
Okay, we'll just go through this. Oh, drain the water out of the pub. That's what it would have done. There we go. So what are we going to use the gun for? Shooting the fan, maybe? Just try to use it on everything. What do I use it on? I don't think there's anything else I can do in there. So there has to be something I do here. I just don't know how to stop his welder. That's all I don't understand. There's been an awful lot of silence, and I do apologize for that. But I'm just unsure about what to do. Quietness in this video. That's just purely because I cannot figure out what to do. Clearly I have to get through that underground piece, but I just have no idea how. Shot him. It was me.
Hello? Is anyone in here? Oh, drat. The muzzle split. I guess this gun was a bit too rusty after all.
It was me.
There's blood on the handle.
I'll try that door actually as well. So we figured it. Figured it out after all that time. Oh, that's how we got through.
Nuts.
Yeah, we need that thing. So that is how we get through. So we need to go back. We need to cut his wire. Cut his wire and steal the wrench. I would have honestly just shot it. It would have been quicker. We're now back through the vent. Old Burt Reynolds. So we were the one who shot the guy. Why'd he tell people it was a parking attendant? Or why'd he tell us it was a parking attendant? So where's the tinfoil hat come from? So that was someone else. Maybe we're the reason for the outbreak. I reckon we're the reason for the outbreak. Anything to tamper with it though. Oh.
Hey.
Green level 4 card.
Hang on.
This does not seem to indicate the pathogen is altered when subject to the time travel. The variety is ludicrous, of course. Time travel does not affect matter, but the numbers don't lie. The airborne nature of the pathogen makes it extremely difficult to identify the host. We are conducting systematic area sweeps.
Hang on.
Someone smashed it. Someone's already in there.
Ah.
So we need to smash that. It's all the cryo place. Clearly. Dead bloke. Another dead bloke. So it was clearly us.
Frank?
Oh! Hey, Joe.
He's
I didn't see you there. Scared the crap out of me.
I can't believe you're here. They told me you quit. I got to go upstairs and everything.
Quit? Oh, right! Yeah, well, you know me. I'm a career opportunity guy. Something else came up.
Management gave me your job. Well, sort of. The same responsibilities, at least. And, well, my own, so...
Is that right? Well, good on you, Joe. Best of luck. Now, if you'll excuse...
They said you already left. Did you forget something?
No. Yeah. I forgot something. Listen, I'm a little tight on time here. Wait, what are you even doing down here?
Well, like I said, I was given your job, so...
Oh, right, right. Well, still, this part of the labs is actually off-limits, so you probably shouldn't be here.
No, right. I know. I just happened to see you, so... Well, I need to get going, too. There's some important... there's a spill I need to mop up. Hey, can we grab a beer down at Izzy's when this is over? This week, I mean. I could really use the company.
Beer? Oh, yeah, yeah, for sure.
Great. Guess I'll leave you to it then.
Unlocked filing cabinet.
Ow!
What am I got a camera for though? What am I taking a picture of? So I have to destroy that somehow. Oh, this is gonna be an awfully long recording, but I didn't have a chance to not do it. So there's something I have to do, Danny. Take a picture of the old mate and then use that in the retina scanner. Put that in there. Oh, I'll probably have to get soil from this fucking thing. Where do I get some dirt from? It'll be how I do it. Where was the dirt? I don't think there's any in here, strangely. I need some dirt, but I don't understand.
No. No.
I do not understand. No dirt, there's no nothing, except for this corpse. There is literally nothing else I can do. God. So how do I pick it up? How do I pick it up, for fuck's sake? There has to be a container or something I can grab. That I'm just missing because I'm an idiot. Spying on the sky is all bent out of shape and both his legs are broken. His left arm isn't even connected to the shoulder. Like, clearly I need to bring the dirt here, but... There's nothing I can grab. I just don't understand. I can't grab a bin or anything. And there is nothing around. So I can't scoop anything. There's just literally nothing I can do.
No. No.
I just don't understand. Yeah, I'm really, really lost. Fuck me, that's ridiculous. That is ridiculous.
There you are! Why the hell haven't you done anything about that leak yet?
The leak?
Hello? Anyone home? The leak next door, numbnuts. Do you have any idea how much the research in those file cabinets is worth? No, of course not. How could you? Just fix that leak, or so help me God, I'll have HR fix your walking papers. Wait. Look, I'm sorry. We're all under quite a bit of stress right now. I'm on my third pot of coffee and haven't had a thing to eat yet.
I could get you something from the vending machine if...
Vending machine? Vending machine? Gee, thanks, Professor. I never thought of that. If I could have something from the vending machine... Don't you think I would have? I didn't spend 8 years at Cornell earning 2 doctorates just to have some schmuck buy my lunch. I'm on a diet, moron. Sorry, I'm getting agitated again.
Diet? I'm not sure I...
It's an all-fruit diet. The missus ordered me on it after my last physical. The irony is that it's supposed to help me with my high blood pressure, but now I'm just as angry all the time from low blood sugar. Tell you what, you find me some fruit, then cover for me while I slip out for a quick break, and I won't report you for the leak. Anything will do. Nectarine, perhaps, or an apple? Yeah, an apple. That's the ticket.
I'll find you an apple.
Make sure that you do. And fix that damn leak! Sorry. Temper again.
Whatever, buddy. I take that one.
Is this some kind of joke? What's the matter with you?
I'm so sorry.
Clearly you won't take
that
one.
Don't know what I was thinking.
I need something to fucking... I need something to carry it. Ugh. Yeah, finally. Surely he's like someone would notice you doing that. Oh look, our mate's gone. Why would he leave that note if I've already been down here? Wonder how the tinfoil hat comes into it. He just went through time. Clearly. Dong. We're part of the problem. It's like a never-ending circle of shit going wrong. I would say. even though this has taken me like a ridiculous amount of time. Oh. Meanwhile.
This means that from now on, you will be in charge of not only yours, but Frank's assignments too. That's right. That means downstairs lab sanitation, drain assignments, the works, with all the clearance that...
I thank you. Wow! Nice!
Got an actual apple for you, bruh.
And you brought me an apple. Good. There's no eating in the lab, so I'll just pop out for a few to get some fresh air. Anyone asks, I'm up on 14 redacting Tuesday's pathology reports. Got it? Just don't touch anything.
So we wrecked the computer, but it's not going to make any difference, clearly. I wonder if you did it quicker, if it would change. Oh, so he's already found it.
Should I be writing this down? I don't have anything to write with.
Shut up and pay attention! You are standing on the brink of an extinction-level event sent in motion by greedy halfwits that will eventually end the lives of every man, woman, and child on the planet.
Crap. Whoa! Poor Dr. Lambert.
Keep your voice down!
Yikes!
Shh!
You're alive?
Well, for a little longer at least.
But how?
I faked it.
Faked what?
You detailed this exact scenario to me 40 years ago, remember? Of course you do. To you, it was a mere day ago. The earlier version of you had to see me die and get dragged off, so as not to alter the course of action that brought you to my doorstep in the first place. And yet I had to survive long enough to assist you in carrying out your mission. So I staged my premature demise.
So, you're not dying?
Oh, I am dying, all right. Despite my better judgment, I attempted to circumvent getting shot by taking a different route to the labs than originally planned. I foolishly believed I might actually bend the rules of cause and effect. The gaping hole in my gut makes it pretty damned evident how that turned out.
Dr. Lambert, I...
No more questions. Did you destroy the research data like I asked?
The computer? Yes, sir. Yes, I did.
Thank God. Now there is just one last matter to attend to. I need you to stop the last time, pilot. The one who just left. Fortunately, we know exactly where, or should I say when, he is. The device. Give it to me. You see that console behind you? Check the numbers in the first line of the fourth column and read them back to me.
First line of the fourth column.
429-496-7295.
Are you sure that's correct?
I'm sure.
Dear God. I have configured the device to return you to the same destination. Here, take the device.
Where do you think
we'll
end up?
End this. One last thing. You can never, never...
Probably Dr. Lambert?
Return.
Are you... Dr. Lambert? Sir?
No!
Someone died. Someone's been here before. Possibly himself. First ever time he went there. So someone's made it themselves. The cloth. Wipe the thing, and then it'll get some, it'll power whatever I need to see back in that room. Probably another dead guy. We'll be the one that starts it, because we'll come back in the time machine. Run, mate, run. We got a machete, now we can go Jason, Burt Reynolds, on all this shit. I would have thought that might have been a sneak compartment when under that tree, but I guess not. I can't even look at the graves. You need something sharper than a machete. Starts.
Frank?
You fucking idiot, Frank.
Joe! Oh. Please. Need. Water.
What are you?
Please!
I'll get you some water. Hang in there.
He'll be dead by the time we get back. Are we meant to not let him survive? Or do we not realize that's him because we're an idiot? Fill up the cup with person stuck in the wall. That's what I'd do. That seems like the logical step. I reckon he'll be dead. Run, you fucking lazy prick. Can I just put out a fire?
No.
That's a bit shit that you can't do that.
Here you go, Frank.
Oh, thank you.
What am I doing over here?
I don't understand. What are you doing here? Where are we?
I'm not sure. I had no time. I pushed it as far as it'd go. But from what I've been reading, everything gets imprecise the farther you travel. Even your physical location can get messed up. Nobody's been this far. We could be hundreds, maybe thousands of years in the future for all I know.
I don't get it. So you're a time pilot now?
Do I really need to spell it out for you, Joe? I stole it.
What? You stole the time machine, but why?
Look, I've got no reason to tell you, but I guess it doesn't matter. You're the last person I'll be sharing anything with anyway. The truth is, I'm a Soviet agent.
Cut it out, Frank. I'm not falling for that one again.
I'm not joking.
Frank, you're just sick, confused. Come on, you can't be. Where's your Russian accent?
Joe, I'm an undercover agent deployed by the Kremlin. My job is to fit in. How far do you think I'd get if I went around calling everyone comrade?
What an idiot.
My real name is Yuri Barishev. I came to America in my early 20s. I went to school here, worked here, spent nearly 10 years building the foundation of an ordinary life. But the truth is that my life is far from ordinary. I am a spy. I was planted by the Soviet Foreign Intelligence Agency to gather intel on advanced U.S. military research programs. And I started getting my first missions in the mid-60s. At the time, I thought I had built a promising portfolio of leads, but as I started to pursue them, most of them turned out to be worthless. By 1968, I had run out of goodwill with my handlers at the Kremlin. I was a disgrace, and headed for extraction. Desperate for something, anything to report, I came across a Canadian company moving large shipments of iridium, osmium, rare metals not typically used in mainstream manufacturing. The buyer turned out to be a government shell, rerouting the materials to unofficial contractors, one of which turned out to be Archon. Having convinced my superiors that I was onto something, I got a job as a janitor. But I didn't dig up much until you showed up. You were a great distraction, giving me plenty of chances to access off-limits areas. And for a while, I was able to scrounge together enough intel to keep the Kremlin happy. Was correct, but I didn't have the full picture. Not yet. The metals were being used to build something unusual, all right. But I just couldn't piece it together. What I found made no sense. Time travel, doomsday scenarios. It read like bad science fiction. For a while, I thought they were onto me, feeding me bogus information. But as time went on, with security tightening around the labs and no one confronting me, I began to suspect that my intel was legit. But time was running out, with Brezhnev and your President Nixon set to negotiate the nuclear disarmament treaty in a few weeks. My superiors were demanding results. My job on the line, I got desperate and careless. And this morning, I got caught. I was tailing an engineer into an off-limits lab when I bumped into Barney from security. Ironically, management chalked up my trespassing to cluelessness and settled for just firing me. Knowing I wouldn't get another chance, I stole a security badge and snuck back in. I just found the time machine operator's manual when you showed up out of nowhere and nearly screwed it all up. Then it clicked. Not only could I steal the technology, it was the perfect getaway, too. Using the manual, I set the destination as high as it would allow. I figured if I could just get far away, I'd have plenty of time to figure out how to get it back to the motherland. But, well, I guess you know the rest. Listen, Joe. I'm really sick, and I'm not making it back. But you still can. The time machine has a timer, like a toaster. It's designed to return home unless the timer's reset. I removed the main power supply fuse to keep it from taking off without me. Here, take it. I have no idea how you got here, and I guess it doesn't matter. Still, despite my mission, a double life, and the deceit, your friendship was always genuine. You're an honest guy, Joe. And I've really enjoyed your company. No, please leave me. The pain's coming back. No, oh, it hurts to talk. Need rest.
Could you chuck this in the fire? Yeah, we're not meant to get out. Because we're sick. So we are going to be at the start of it. will be patient zero. Because we came back like an idiot. Weird part is you can't not do it.
Can't be.
Yeah, I'm patient zero, clearly.
The foreign organism. It's me. I brought back the disease.
No shit.
I'm the one who spreads it.
No shit.
It was me all along. I must have brought it back with me. Oh God. I think I'm gonna throw up. I can't deal with this. What do I do?
So is that all we're gonna do? Take it, we are in a hospital.
What? Okay. Personal space.
I was going to stop the recording now and stop playing, but...
Damn.
he figured it out.
No way to escape it. No way out, no way out, no way out.
I'm sorry, what?
End of days. Scourge and sickness. The cleansing of the earth. The overlords conspired against us. Tricked us. Made us bring the poison back into the nest. Like good little ants.
Who did?
Too late. What's done is done. No backseats. But we must try. Do you hear me?
Sure.
The key to salvation. I've seen it. Felt its color. Know its shape. They don't know that I know. Oh, no. But I know. I know. Write it. Write it, write it, write it! Before it disappears. Write it down before it disappears. Took away my tools. I'll forget without my tools.
Your tools?
Pens, paper. They're erasing the slate, forcing me to forget. Trying to break my resolve. The persistence of memory, I must repeat, repeat, repeat all the time, repeat. Oh, they fear me. Cower at the sight of scientific rigor. They know I'm close, so they take away my tools. But I'll show them. The blinding light of the scientific method casts no shadows.
So we now have a TV remote. Maybe we can turn off the TV. So he left straight away, he's probably on the computer. Jittery man.
Need paper to reproduce the key. Need the paper. Gotta have paper.
He'll give us the key to the door.
Mightier than the sword. The pen, the pen, the pen. The key. The key. Keep it close. Keep it safe. Bring help. Don't get caught. Save the kingdom, get the girl. Save the kingdom, get the girl. Save the kingdom, get the girl.
He's lost it. I think my computer is still going. I do apologize for this, but this is a really awkward time for this to happen.
Miss, nurse,
Oh, hi there. Goodness, you startled me. You could have just knocked. And it's Doctor, actually, Dr. Emma Brown. I'm a little embarrassed to say, but we don't have any files on you, so I don't even know your name.
It's Joe, ma'am.
Oh, call me Emma. We're not so formal here. It's nice to meet you, Joe.
I'm sorry, Dr. Brown. I don't know how to say this, but you, everyone here, is in serious danger. I'm very sick, and it's very important you call the authorities and...
Whoa. Take it easy. Deep breaths. There's nothing to be afraid of. How do you feel?
Okay, I guess. A little sore.
See, you're fine. And the soreness is to be expected. You've undergone muscle therapy. You've been asleep for at least 3 decades, after all. Maybe even more.
What? Where am I? What year is this?
Easy, Joe. I know it's a lot to take in. It'd be a shock to anyone's system. Haven't been under for as long as you have. It's 2012, and this is the psychiatric ward at St. Genevieve's Hospital. You were brought out of hibernation 5 weeks ago. Like the others, you were placed in an artificial coma for regenerative muscle therapy and brought here for evaluation and rehab after everything checked out.
Oh, God. The tubes. You have to listen to me, Doctor. I'm dangerously sick. I was carrying something when I got in.
Oh, that? Well, that's true. You did all have some kind of flu. Actually, the resident physician did find it peculiar how you had all contracted a type of avian flu that only first appeared in the late 90s, and a new strain at that. In any case, the pathogen was largely dormant due to the extended hibernation. We run very thorough medical checks on all our cryo clients, so we gave you all a shot of our regular cocktail. Cleared it right up before you even came to.
So it's gone? But Archon...
Yes, I'm afraid I don't know much about all of that. All I know is that the company that froze you went bankrupt back in the early 70s. A victim of industrial sabotage, I think. Anywho, the remaining assets were sold off, and the Cryoform company bought the cryogenics technology. As per ethical requirements, that included all of you who were frozen there. We've been helping rehabilitate Cryoform's clients for the past 5 years or so. Mostly folks suffering from previously incurable terminal illnesses and heavy wallets. But you didn't hear that from me, hmm? Unfortunately, cryogenics was a little... experimental when you went under. So, while the company's been freezing and reviving clients for quite some time, you had to stay confined to the original equipment. Apparently, a lot of Archon's original documentation was destroyed in a fire. So Cryoform had practically no information on any of you. That's another reason it took so long to figure out how to revive you. Sadly, the others haven't been quite as coherent. They share certain delusions, you know, end of the world, that sort of thing. An unfortunate side effect of cryogenics' primitive state at the time, I suspect. You, however, seem just fine. Apart from the shock, I mean.
So I'm not sick? You sure?
Yes, Joe, quite sure. In fact, I see no reason to keep you here. We have an excellent rehabilitation team who'll get you settled into your new life in no time. Just come see me when you're ready to go.
So I walked into that before I could talk to her.
So, are we all ready to go?
I guess.
Oh, don't worry. The rehab team's eager to help get you settled in. I know it may feel a little overwhelming now, but trust me, you'll love it in 2012. Endless opportunities. A whole new lease on life. Speaking of, I happened to catch you on the surveillance monitors a little while ago, and you seem to show excellent problem-solving skills. You like puzzles, Joe?
I...
Perfect. I'll be sure to mention it to the career coaches. They'll find just the right thing for you.
So I guess we stopped it then. Where we could have just not come back in time. But that didn't seem to be an option, unfortunately. Still all zombies. Maybe that's what it's trying to say. I don't know. Ending's a bit shit. We shouldn't have come back. And I'm going to presume that's the end of the game. Or is it? That's what it looks like. So, I just clicked to get rid of that. That was the end of the Silent Age. So for 99 cents, that was 2.5 hours worth of game. Just over. So there is no different way you can take it. Yeah, for 99 cents, it's over 2.5 hours. I didn't think it was going to go this long, so this is a massively long video, so I do apologise for that. There's probably a lot of non-talking during a lot of it, but I get distracted sometimes, so I do apologise for that. But if you did watch it all, cheers for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.